Hello, my name is Paul. This is the Co-Creative Intimacy Podcast. We address issues of faith, intimacy, and communication. Today's question is, what is your Bible? What is the Bible, or what is your Bible?
Bible means is a learning lesson, a lesson to be taught by others, and a tool to follow your own faith, a development of your own religious beliefs.
Okay, thank you. Felicia, you were going to say something?
I've seen people refer to Bible in a couple of different ways. So to me, it just seems like something that is either authoritative or something that you read slash look up to for either answers, inspiration, or things along that nature.
Yeah. So I was in the bookstore and I saw something. It said, it was something to do with a cooking Bible, meaning that somebody had like these amazing recipes, and this is all the great stuff that we have about cooking.
Right, like it has all the answers.
Yes, yes, yeah. Rose, any thoughts about the Bible?
To me, my Bible is the inspired Word of God that has 66 books, being an Old Testament and a New Testament, one before the birth of Jesus Christ and one after.
Beautiful. Wow, that was a mouthful. Thank you.
Very
okay,
well,
so I think everybody's right. I want to call attention to the word Bible comes from the Latin meaning biblia. And you've seen the word biblia used in, like, say, the back of a book or the back of a long research book. And it's, what do you see there? The list of books is called a bibliography.
Oh.
Yeah, okay.
So a bibliography is a list of books. So a Bible is a collection of books. But the thing is, now I am Christian, so I have my Bible, but depending on who you are, your Bible may be different. So let's say, what if you were Mormon? What would you call your Bible?
The Book of Mormon?
Yes. Yes. Now what about if you were Hindu?
Ooh, I used to know this answer.
Is it like
the Bhagavad Gita?
Yes, the Bhagavad Gita, yes. Oh. And if you're Muslim, it would be
Quran.
The Quran. Very good.
Yeah. I know that one.
So now let's talk about Judaism and Christianity. So I'm a Christian. Typically, people like to say things like New Testament and Old Testament. And I find that a little, it depends on who you're talking to. If I'm talking to only Christians, then those words make sense because your Bible is the same as my Bible. Yeah. But if I'm talking to a group of people where I don't know where their background is with spirituality or religion, I will tend not to use words like Old Testament and New Testament. And if you're Jewish, you're... what I would call, might call the Old Testament is really your full Testament. So it seems to me proper to call it what it is, which is the Hebrew scriptures. And the New Testament is the Christian scriptures. So I tend to, and this is something I learned back in seminary, to use the terms Hebrew scriptures, Christian scriptures, because those are correct always. They're never wrong. And you're never going to offend anybody.
Yeah.
Yeah, I would say I have the same feeling as you are, but I myself am not a Christian or any of religious. I'm more myself an agnostic, so I'm more selective when I come to like more of a teaching learnings. So I always follow like what the teaching of their own definitions and what I believe in them was right for me, you know, like right or wrong. And what I learned from the Bible or Quran, the Torah or Mormon, everything else I learned by listening and understanding the concept of their own following beliefs. So
what I heard from you is that you recognize that different faith traditions have their Bible and you welcome them all as possible ways to learn and grow.
Yeah.
So I think it's important to own your Bible.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. So I think I like that question. What is your Bible? That's it. Today we learned that the word Bible comes from the Latin biblia, which means collection of books. So what is your collection of books? If you're Jewish, it would be the Hebrew scriptures. If you're Christian, it would be the Hebrew scriptures and the Christian scriptures, also known as the Old and New Testament. Thanks for coming, and I'll see you next time.